Hello, everyone. Hoot hoot, everyone. It's me, Ethan, that there Turbo Owl. And I'm just here with a bit of an old brand new stream. Last night, I played, as I'm sure you'll recall, Iron Lung, the new horror short horror experience from the developer of Dusk. It was good and scary. And then while I was watching it, someone said something about H.P. Lovecraft while I was playing that. And that caused me to go off on a tear about H.P. Lovecraft, you know, Cthulhu mythos lore, which resulted in, yep, there he is, my friend Edit Edward, insisting that he was going to buy me Sucker for Love, the Cthulhu-themed dating sim game. I woke up today to a copy of Sucker for Love, so instead of playing Lobotomy Corporation, we're going to be playing this. However, I am going to warn you right now that my voice is fucked for a very silly reason. Now, I don't know if I've ever mentioned this. I think you can probably pick this up just by me. You know, the kind of guy I am. But I am intensely lame. Combined with the fact that I like a lot of edgy shit, which, you know, again, you can tell I'm both lame and like edgy shit just by looking at me. Basically, I was listening to old Lordy albums before I started streaming, and I was singing along, doing my best impression of the lead singer, Mr. Lordy, who has a very gravelly voice. So I basically tore my throat apart just before I was streaming for no reason. I did that to myself. I played myself. Okay. Let's hit the transition button here and go with that. But yeah, just bear in mind, bear in mind that my throat isn't great, for that reason. I'm deeply dumb. Okay, Sucker for Love, first date. I don't know why it's called first date. There is, like, the Sucker for Love prologue, which from what I understand, I think was, like, a much shorter version of the game. I think this was originally part of, like, a compilation of horror games, if I remember correctly. It might have been, like, one of those Dread X collection things. I think this might have been part of that, and then there was the prologue that was part of one of those. In my mind, if I was releasing a prologue to a game called Sucker for Love, I would have called the prologue, First Date, not the full game. Prelude was a game jam game from the same lot that did Inscription, I believe. Yeah, Dread X. Yeah, I thought it was that. Never played it before. This is completely blind. I am just dimly aware that this is a, I gotta assume, at least somewhat comedic and tongue-in-cheek, Cthulhoid dating sim. Let's hit new game and hope it doesn't go into gross situations. Okay. Well, okay, so we've got three options here. I can only click on Cthulhu right now. I'm gonna tell you immediately, I'm pretty sure I know. So I'm gonna go ahead and assume these are three different girls. Or at least they introduce different characters. This one's obviously Cthulhu. I can't see any details on who this one is, but there's a lot of yellow, so I'm gonna go ahead and say Hasta the Unspeakable. And this is an Egyptian-themed thing, so that's just definitely Neolathotep. But let's click this. Let's click the only option we have. Lynetta, my really, oh god.
Chapter 1, Lynetta, my really scary girlfriend.
That's not how Relay is pronounced though, game, is it? I talked about this yesterday. Is this why you wanted, but just because you knew I'd be angry at that? Now there is voice acting, but is it just, it might just be for the girls, so I'm guessing I'm going to be doing some reading. Eldritch gods, cosmic horrors, things beyond our understanding. To merely gaze upon their form is to abandon all hope. The only thing It's just the characters and one of the intros. Okay. The only thing protecting all of reality from the final coalescence of insanity and terror is the fact that the unspeakable gods wait dreaming. Their awakening under aligned stars heralds the end. Today, the stars are aligned. Damn it. Come on already. Same day shipping, Maya. So, this is, I assume... I'm assuming this is our bedroom. We got a turtle. Oh my god, sorry, I just realized that, like, the lamp in the room is actually... Like, our hand is actually casting a shadow from the light in the room. Which worries me, because that implies that this hand has a physical presence in the space, which is a kind of upsetting. Yeah, we got a little toidle. We got... Whatever this is. Candyman 1991, number 1D. Let's visiting D-Coon. Only at Candyman. I don't know what this is. Okay. I'm gonna ignore that. We got obvious, like, Cthulhu cultist get up here. We got a big knife up here. Also, there's a logo up here. I don't know what this is for. You can't quite see it. It's like the logo for the game. That might just be the menu. If I were to guess. I don't want to click it in case that's not what it is. But I think that's probably just, like, to get to the menu, maybe. I only have half an hour tops until the stars move out of position. Oh, we are gonna be conjuring up an Elder God. I mean, okay, we got the cultist to get up here, so that makes sense. Better wash my face to calm down. Oh, that's us! We're D. Okay. Well, on the plus side, at least we're not just like a floating hand, which I genuinely thought it might be. A year ago, I saw the face of an eldritch being in my dreams. It whispered its name to me. Lynetta. Ever since, I've been obsessed with trying to see it again. I'm not the kind of person to get addicted to stuff or spend recklessly. You've got a golden D on a necklace, Randy. You're not... That's not a good... I don't care who you are, that's not a good purchase. But I just can't help myself. There's something I have to do once I see it again. I have to fuck the tentacle woman. Was that the door? Thank goodness. I spent way too much. Okay. The fact that his name is just D is bugging the shit. Is this the secret backstory to D, Hunter of the Dead from Elden Ring? Is this the secret backstory to the character that is transparently just a reference to Vampire Hunter D? I spent way too much money on getting this for me. I spent way too much money on getting this for me to miss my chance. The amount of money I've lost to scammers claiming to have the real deal is a little embarrassing. But as of today, I'll have a genuine Necronomicon, an ancient spellbook containing the dark rituals needed to contact the Elder Gods. Hey, game, you're going to say the name of the guy who wrote the Necronomicon? At any point, you're going to bring up, and I'm going to, because it's... How are you raiding? I mean, thanks for raiding, but how? Mechanically, you've been talking in the chat. How are you? I'm gonna ignore that. A stream specifically for raiding. Oh, okay. That's it. You just confused the shit out of me. I was like, what the fuck? That's still weird. That's still fucking weird. Okay. You've distracted me. I have a genuine Necronomicon, an ancient spellbook containing the dark rituals needed to contact the Elder Gods. Tim, stop sulking. Come here. Finally, That is a very pink Necronomicon. That is a deeply pink Necronomicon. An excruciatingly pink Necronomicon. But yeah, just for the purposes of mentioning, in case anyone doesn't know, the reason I'm wondering if the game is going to mention the name of the guy who wrote the Necronomicon is because, if I remember correctly, whenever he's mentioned, his name is always said in full as the Mad Arab Abdul Azarad. Or Ahazrad. There's a H in there somewhere, but I'm not sure where it is. But he's never just Abdul Azarad. He's always the Mad Arab Abdul Azarad. Huh? What the hell is this? Why is it pink? Isn't this supposed to be, like, brown and bigger? Abdul as fuck me. Fuck me running. As Hazard. I mean, it's... Fuck, it doesn't matter. He's just called the Mad Arab. He's called the Mad Arab Abdul something or other. As Hazard. No, fuck the stream. I'm just going to be practicing saying his name. Abdul As Hazard. There we go. Close enough. They're not going to mention it. It's a waste of time. It's supposed to be an ancient book covered in flesh or something, but this looks like it just came from an office supply store. No, please don't tell me. Scammed again. With how much money I spent this time, I thought there'd be no chance it'd be fake. You see, that's the thing. If you're ever worried about being scammed, all you need to do is you need to spend as much money as possible, because that means it's less likely. Doesn't mean you're just going to lose more. It's fine. Great! No, I'm getting my money back on either. The scammer's probably long gone, too. Damn it, I need a new hobby, seriously. What a strange scam, though. You'd think they'd at least try to go for an authentic look. Did they really think nobody would notice that their Book of the Dead is Malibu pink? Wait, is this symbol on the front embossed? Is this thing made of real leather? The pages look gilt and gold, too. Wait, this guy has a poster of himself above his bed. Yeah! Yeah, he does, yeah. I don't get it. I would not want a post. I mean, actually, you know what? No, I was gonna say, I don't get that. And while I wouldn't do that, how many rich, famous people in history have paid out the nose to put fucking, to get big portraits of themselves? Yeah, I think that might genuinely, he gifted a sub. Edward gifted a sub. That might genuinely be the first time anyone has gifted a sub on my... Yeah, that is the first time anyone has ever gifted a sub to someone on my streams. Fantastic. I mean, I fucking give you my Prime sub, you piece of shit. Okay. And thank you for the follow, Thunderwolf123. Fantastic. The problem is now, I'm realizing I'm getting distracted talking to chat in a game that is dead silent and text on the screen. Which isn't ideal. Yeah, I have a legacy in this world before it ends. I'm not gonna lie to you. I have donated subs to one friend of mine. One friend of mine's stream. Purely, I donated three. Purely because the top person had two. And I wanted to have my name on his streams. Pure spite, I did that. I don't know if it's still there. It's been fucking like a year since I did it. And this weight, why'd they make a knockoff out of such high-quality materials? Oh my. Oh, my computer. It's probably just the delivery confirmation message. <laughs> 100% real Necronomicon, not clickbait, not a scam, gone sexual, arriving tomorrow. What the? My order was delayed? It won't be delivered until tomorrow? Then... what the hell is this book supposed to be? Did it get delivered to me by accident or something? There's no shipping label on the box. Stranger still, the guy who delivered it was like... Cthuloid. He was octopodal. Yeah. Stranger still, there's an inscription at the bottom. I'm just still angry at the fact that the game... pronounced relay as really. Rulian! The unholy language of the Eldritch gods. Honestly, if I were to take a guess, I would imagine the intended pronunciation of relay might be Rulia. Because, you know, that entire language of the Deep Ones is supposed to be explicitly unpronounceable. So we just have to, like, be roughly guessing. So it's probably closer to Rulia than it is to anything else, because that is the furthest away from a reasonable sounding word. Also, the books, the pages reek of formaldehyde, the embalming fluid. In other words, it stinks of death. Why would something so cute have such an insidious aura around it? Maybe I'll take a look inside. Oh god, we've got UI. Wait. Wait. Okay, I can make the room pink. Yeah, I'm okay, yeah, I am. I'm gonna get rid of that poster. That's just odd. God, I'm laughing at the noise of it. Wait, if I take him, is he in my inventory? Yes. Yes, he is. Cool. Nope. 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 What? No. What? Okay, wait. Shit. Okay. Where? Where? That! No. Okay, that is the... Okay, there was a logo up here that was the options button. Got that. Okay, I just realized that I just picked up a sacrificial dagger. Remember that while you have the turtle for the rituals, heresy isn't real. Hello, Tarnished. I'm a turtle with a mitre. Heresy isn't real. Do you want to learn a spell? Ensure all possible light has been snuffed from the room. Oh, I don't need all of these. Okay. So I need the necklace. Draw my curtains. I don't know. No. I don't need fucking Rillian. Close my curtains. Off with the lights. Turn off my bedside lamp. Cool. In the dark. Put those on. Fine, I put on my ritual necklace and then... Okay! I mean, that already is like a somewhat female-looking Cthulhu there. I have a suspicion that the Inquisition might not be pleased with this. Nah, it's fine. Heresy's not real. Don't worry about it.
Mortal.
Cool. Am I dead? Or is this the core? Hello. Oh god, it actually worked. She's here. A beacon of madness is towering over me. An omnipotent, chaotic avatar of world-ending calamity. Even with a year of preparation for this moment, I'm frozen in fear.
For what purpose have you awoken Lynetta the Starspawn and brought about the end of reality?
I mean, I think to date her is what our guy summoned him for. Summoned her for him. For it. It? Her? It? It. Gang Lady Dimitrescu. I'm not gonna lie, the fact that it specified towering over did all. I did immediately think about of Lady Dimitrescu. I can't talk. I can't even breathe. Blinding dread, choking terror. My very sanity is teetering on the precipice. And looking down. No, I finally got this far. I finally have my chance. I can't perish now. Dark One, I ask that you grant my wish. It's a deep one, not a genie. Actually, no, it's not even a deep one. It's a starspawn. Yeah, it's a Cthulhu starspawn. It's a little, I want to quickly... Cthulhu isn't a god. Cthulhu is a high priest. There are gods in this setting, in the Lovecraft mythos, and in the Cthulhu mythos, and Cthulhu ain't one of them. As you grant my wish.
You wish to be the first human to be destroyed, yes? So that you are spared from the cataclysm I shall wreak upon all life.
I do enjoy that specific. That's not just being edgy, that is often the stated goal of many Cthulhu cults in the Lovecraft mythos. Exactly what I'm here for. The deepest lore. But yeah, no, genuinely, it's explicitly stated in a lot of, I'm gonna deal with that in a minute. I'm gonna deal with that in a minute, okay? But in the Cthulhu mythos, a lot of Cthulhu cults, it's a mixture of sorcerers who think that by worshipping the old ones and the elder gods and shit like that, they can get power. And the rest of them are just like, well, we've seen the truth of the universe, we're tiny and weak and pathetic, and we're gonna get destroyed by monsters, so we might as well die first, so we're spared the hell that is the world that they're going to create once they're born. That's it was a good reference to a frequently stated motivation for most Cthulhu cultists. It would make sense why a Starspawn would assume that's why they've been summoned. No! I want to smooch you! Cool. Yeah, great. Excellent. Fantastic. Just in me. Is that actually hair? I feel like it's going to turn out that there's a smooch button. I hadn't noticed there was a smooch button. Was that always there and I just hadn't spotted that somehow? I want to smooch.
Say it again, creep. Why are you looking directly at me without being even mad?
Okay. That's fair. I'm mad with lust.
Send me back.
Fantastic. sorry that the Starspawn is not into this at all has entertained me as much. Can I just say how much I love her voice actress, Michaela? That's got to be Michaela because Michelle is not a name. Michaela does such a good job selling it. Huh? But you just got here. What about destroying reality as I know it?
I'll do it next time. Maybe when the stars realign in 1,000 years or so.
But I'll be long dead
exactly.
By then. Yeah, I was gonna say, yeah, exactly. No, good. Hey, I went through all the trouble of finding this damn book. The least you could... I've immediately the player character sucks. He's like, hey, I put so much effort in. I deserve affection from you. I'm entitled to your affection, horrifying Starspawn. It's gross. It's not good. That's not it, Chief.
Where'd you get that book?
Is this a Cthulhu dating sim? Yes. Yes. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Huh? What? This? I found it outside my door.
Moo. Always trying to set me up with someone.
Moo. I'm racking my brain trying to think. Maybe I don't have enough information to figure out what that's a reference to. Moo, who's that? They the one who left this funny looking Necronomicon on my doorstep?
It's not a Necronomicon.
What is it then? It's not?
The Necronomicon is bright pink, silly.
This one? God, she's cute. But what's with the sudden personality change? Does she recognize the book? Okay, D is also thick as mints, because he's a, just, she, clear, like, I have never seen, look, I'm autistic, alright, I'm not great at reading social cues, I could figure out this motherfucker knows what this book is based on the context of this situation. I don't know how D over here doesn't, then again, his name is one letter, he's not great. Mu is a lost continent that now lies at the bottom of the Pacific Ocean, it's connected to numerous aspects of the Cthulhu mythos. Okay. Well, if it's not a Necronomicon, what is it?
It's a survival guide.
A survival guide to dating Cthulhoid entities, I assume? For what?
Me.
Cool, excellent. Fantastic. What? Really? This thing?
It's full of rituals that I like. Offerings, spells, and how to protect your sanity while performing them.
Ah, okay. That's explicitly why we didn't go mad. Upon seeing her, because we had the stuff. Cool. I struck gold! All the money I spent finally paid off! Wait, what'd you just say? Protect my sanity?
I'm a cosmic entity beyond comprehension. So no amount of contact with me is safe for a human. Your mind could snap like a reed at any moment, actually.
He skipped to the end of the clip then. You know, I do wonder if that is a thing, like, what? Because I'm guessing I saw the page after this, like, the first ritual. So I'm guessing that each page is just in, like, text, as opposed to anything we can read until we get to, like, the appropriate part of the game. Gulp? I turned to Goofy. Don't worry about it.
Don't make that face. I can make it worth your while, if you understand what I'm getting at.
Fucking? Are you talking about fucking? You'll let me smooch you? Okay, sorry. Apparently, I'm slightly grosser than the game, because I immediately just said fucking, and the game's like, hold hands, so I...
If you can make it to the end, darling.
Cool.
If you chicken out or go insane, I'll end reality right then and there.
Cool. Will you spare the world if I win that kiss?
No.
Cool, okay. So, world's fucked. It's just waiting. Genuinely, I don't think Dee has any thoughts that said beyond smooching. Again, to be fair, checks out. Again, I don't know how many people watching this have read Lovecraft, but Cthulhu cultists don't tend to be particularly bright. And that's not just because H.P. Lovecraft was horrifyingly racist, and therefore also made all of the cultists into ethnic minorities he didn't like, and then ascribed to them every single negative trait he could think of, including stupidity. I mean, that's a big part of why Cthulhu cultists are all stupid, because H.P. Lovecraft's racist, but generally the cultists that aren't that clever, you know? They also tend to be poor people, with, again, the rare occasions of, like, sorcerer types, who are often very rich and very pleasant and charismatic and likable, and also almost always inexplicably, they just happen to be white. H.P. Lovecraft's horrifyingly racist. One of the things that fucks me off, actually, about a lot of fans of H.P. Lovecraft is how much, like, attempts at justifying or trying to ignore how comically racist he was goes on. It's like, no, he was horribly racist and a terrible human being. You just have to deal with that.
You knew what you were getting into when you woke me up, right, darling?
Looks like my only two options are die or die without getting a kiss. I mean, you could try and shoot her. I mean, that might work for a bit, genuinely. If you get a gun, that might work. I mean, I believe in Call of Cthulhu. It might not be Call of Cthulhu. I think it's the end of Call of Cthulhu. Not the game, the story. I somewhat doubt it will work very well. Well, you say that, but Cthulhu was defeated in the Call of Cthulhu. Granted, that was literally because someone plowed an entire, like, early 1900s steamship into him. Yeah, they ram Cthulhu's head with a ship. Yeah, they literally ram a ship through him. And he, like, dissipated. He started reforming. Like, he wasn't dead, but they temporarily beat him. So it's entirely possible that you could just shoot her, and then that'd be it. For a while. You know, a little bit. She'd destroy the world eventually, but, you know, you could delay it. And ultimately, that's all you can ever do in the Lovecraft mythos, is just, you know, delay the inevitable. Well, they say if you've already eaten the poison, you might as well lick the plate. No. No, they do not. No one says that. You can cure poison. What are you doing? Stop it. Shut up. D, you are so deeply fucking weird. Ah, oh, dear. So if the world is gonna end either way... Deal.
Excellent. Cool. Let's begin the date then. Why don't you start with the Invoke the Depths ritual?
Sick. All right. Okay, let's actually have a look at this book. Okay, yeah, now that she said it, Invoke the Depths. Do not... Oh. That's... Do not look out of your window after performing the ritual. That's rough. But yeah, I'm guessing... Yeah, all the other rituals and stuff are in... in Cthulhoid. Her name. Yeesh. Remember Papers, Please, and the different rules that pile up. Okay. Yeah, I remember. Do not cover your ears. You will need them. Nothing is just your imagination. Okay. Oh, she's just hanging out. Okay. Oh, that's why there's so much interactable shit. Why am I pink now? Oh, is that like a sanity effect? Like, I'm losing my sanity because she's here. Is that what that is? Okay. If that's what that is, that's cool. Okay. So, Do not perform this ritual alone. Snuff out all light in the room. Okay. I'm gonna take, Okay. We're not- okay. Okay, so... Do not perform the ritual alone. I've got my turtle, I'm not on my own. Snuff all light from the room. And turn on... Is it the sink or the shower? Fuck it, I'll do both. Gonna go nuts. Okay. When all is complete, chant. Yep.
Home sweet home.
Cool. What did I just do?
You brought the outer depths to us. Didn't you read the spell's name? Our connection is stronger now. The closer you get to where my true form lies dreaming, the stronger my influence on you in this world.
Will I be a Has our name changed to Darling?
Just focus on following the book perfectly. You're good to start doing these rituals on your own, right?
Yep. Okay, our name did change and now it's Pink again. No, wait. Why are you leaving?
I'm just feeling a little icky from the summoning, so I wanted to use your shower. Do you mind?
Go ahead. No, not at all. Go ahead.
Thanks. No peeking.
Okay.
Don't peek.
Okay, I won't.
Mm-hmm.
I won't!
You sure you won't?
Yeah, I'm sure. I'm positive.
All right, I'll be back in a jiffy.
I know it. Look, okay? I know it's said that we A, shouldn't peek, and B, shouldn't look out the window. But I want to do both. So let's check the window. Cool, I immediately went mad. Bad end. Core invoke depths. Okay. Yep. Cool. Now you see that poster I'm keeping. That poster I like. Like genuinely, that's pretty sick. I honestly, I've got space for one more poster in my room after the Junji Ito poster, but I'll maybe like on that wall. I should get like some like a print of some like really nice Lovecraftian art in here. Okay. Worth it. Oh, is the implication that she plucked our eyes out? Is that the implication? Fascinating. Okay. Okay. What happens if we exit? That's the world looks fine out that door, but if I look out my window, I go nuts. Did I just ruin the world to the left of me? Like, is that what happened? Just everything to the left of my house is screwed. Okay. Abyssal mist. Ensure your sink or shower is running to make the sound of moving water, then go outside. Avoid making eye contact with that which roams the fog. You'll know if you saw them. Turn off your lights before you leave. This one isn't a warning. It'll just help your electricity bill. Okay. I mean, they're both on, so go outside. Jeez, it looks like Quiet Hill out here with all this fog. Didn't go far enough. It should have been. Jesus, it looks like Muffled Mountain out here with all this fog.
Darling, you didn't.
I didn't what?
I love foggy rainy days by the sea. It's like my favorite weather on the surface world.
I feel like your favorite weather on it would be water, underwater. Deep, the water here, you under it. Like, I feel like that's your favorite thing. Stealing Muffled Mountain. Yeah, okay. You could put that on the pile next to the fucking sunglasses you stole from me. As well, you fucking thief. You fucking thief! Okay.
I didn't know you have a house on the water!
Maybe I didn't until now. I didn't 5 minutes ago. Yeah, okay! Yeah, I didn't. I do now, but I didn't before. In fact, I'm hundreds of kilometers from the coast. Even the wildest of hurricanes would never flood the area like this. What terrible power is this thing capable of?
There's something just so romantic about standing on a balcony during a storm.
Not with this music, right? I'd hate to cut the fun short, but can we go back inside? Like, now?
What's wrong, darling? Getting chilly?
It feels like something's watching me from out there.
We can go inside if you like, but it's not like it's any safer in there.
Cool! Thanks! Great! Cheers!
After all, the next page in the book has an unspeakable horror on it.
Unspeakable horror? Some kind of monster's gonna jump out at me?
You'll see what I mean.
Cool. I'm gonna just turn my lights back on. Okay, I'm still pink. Okay. Next page. I don't want to just chant that. Fuck. I just got genuinely slightly startled by a fart noise and I'm furious. What the hell? I can't even begin to pronounce this.
That's why it's an unspeakable horror. Unspeakable. Get it? As in, cannot be spoken. At least not by humans.
Well, can you read it then? It has cat ears. Yeah, no, it's that. I'm trying to not think about that. Wait, you can pronounce this?
Of course I can pronounce anything.
She's got, like, tentacle face. She can probably pronounce anything, yeah. Anything?
Anything.
Cool. Oh, yeah? Then what's this? Fucking Worcestershire. Cool. Good luck. It's a British name. Have fun, dickhead.
Worcestershire sauce?
Damn, you are the real deal. Okay, no, yeah, fair enough. Yeah, okay. She can pronounce Worcestershire sauce. Worcestershire, fuck me. Worcestershire sauce. Sure. Hey, wait a minute. Those tentacles are like extra tongues, right? Then your weakness is tongue twisters. Say toy boat 10 times fast.
Toy boat, 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 toy boat.
Now, I feel like I could, I feel like I could feel, I could hear edits in there. Everyone else get a vague sense like that wasn't one continuous bit of audio? I feel like there might have been edits in there. Show off. Bitch. Eldritch mouth. This ritual allows you to utter unspeakable things. Okay. I'm worried that this is going to involve me literally cutting my mouth open. Given that the only thing I need on me is a knife. When a robes or amulets have a ritual knife on your person. Cool, let's get Eldritch Mouth. Eldritch Mouth, huh? Maybe you should have considered the spell more carefully before casting it. If there's so much as a single scar, I might actually lose my job. Please don't let me have something freaky on my face. It's my livelihood on the line here. Dude! The world is ending in, like, a day! You're fine. It's okay, big breaths, brace yourself. I'm still cute as hell. But I thought I'd get an Eldritch Mouth or something. The picture had it on the hand. Everything seems pretty much the same. Weird. Hey, Lunetta?
Yes?
Cool. I am enjoying the fact that when she suddenly appears, it does like a horrible step. It does very, I think it sounds almost like exactly the static sting from Slender the Eight Pages. Ah! You startled me.
You called me!
Yeah, but you teleported. Ah! Who the hell was that third voice?
What are you talking about? That was you! Look!
She takes a hold of my hand. Whoa, hand holding on the first date? Oh, fuck. I'm gonna remove my Twitch. Moving fast, but
no,
that's okay.
Look at your hand, silly.
My hand? Yeah, it's got a horrible mouth on it. Oh, fuck. What the? Get it off! Quick, help me cut it off! Hurry!
Off? But it's your hand now. See?
Surely enough, it's not a disembodied mouth stuck to my hand. It's a very much embodied mouth, indeed. Is this really my hand? What does that do to my hand? This is screwed up. I mean, I know I'd be in harm's way, but permanent body disfigurement this early on? But I'm not stopping before I get that smooch. No matter what, I just gotta think positive. This isn't so bad. I mean, there's gotta be a silver lining to this. Now I have my pick of which mouth to use when I smooch you. I don't like. There are things in the fog, and someone knocked it. I don't like. There's someone at the door. This is bad. Did I get busted? The sudden shock feels like a splash of cold water that snaps me to my senses. Damn, I must have done something to give us away. Was I shouting too loudly about the knife? Did the neighbors call the cops? If someone interrupts my rituals now, the stars will fall out of alignment before I can finish. Damn it, I even picked the apartment on the top floor to minimize the number of people noticing odd sounds or smells from my room. If it's the police, they're going to insist on looking around. I'm not going to be able to smooth-talk my way out of a demon in my room. She's not a demon, she's a starspawn. Get your fucking terms right, dickhead. Either way, I need to prepare myself now. Who knows how quickly things are going to go south once I answer the door.
Hello, are you in? I heard you shouting just now. Come on, let me in.
Cool, great. Crap, it's even worse than the police. There's only one person it could be, and at the worst possible time. What do I do? Is it even safe to go outside right now with all the world-bending spells I've been casting?
What's that, darling?
I very, very... Who's that? Hey, darling, who's that? Who's that? Who is it? Who is it? Who is it? But probably the mailman. I'll make him leave. Give me a second.
You don't look so good. Maybe I should get the door?
Definitely not. No! I mean, no. I really don't think that's a good idea.
Why not?
You're a... I'm assuming she's tall? It said she loomed over us, so I assume she's tall. Well, you're a mind-flaying goddess. Maybe it'll be too much for someone who wasn't expecting it.
I guess it's a good point.
Yeah, of course it's a good point. Wait here, I'll be right back. Gulp. Gulp? Missy, hey! Good to see
you. I hope it wasn't too forward of me to call upon you in your own private department.
She's wearing a lot of yellow. She's got a lot of yellow. Quite a lot of it. Just quite a lot of yellow going on. Jeez, this motherfucker is... This motherfucker's connected to Haster the Unspeakable. Just say. Hang on. She's wearing a lot of yellow. She's definitely connected to Hastur the Unspeakable, and she very specifically appeared after I used something that allows me to say unspeakable things. That sounds about right. Also, I just want to say, this is what, I think the second time I've, like, been in something vaguely Lovecraftian, and I see yellow, and I go, Hastur the Unspeakable! Because if I remember correctly, when I played, I never finished The Sinking City, but when I was streaming the beginning of The Sinking City, I called that, like, the guy who we meet at the opening of the game, who's in a yellow suit, is definitely a, he's definitely a cultist of the King in Yellow. Like, and then I found out there's a society in that game called the Kings in Yellow as well. Like, it's, nah, Missy, she's an old money rich girl that suddenly showed up to the club I worked at and starts showering me with gifts. Oh, she probably sent us the book. She doesn't quite understand that she's not supposed to contact me outside working hours, but it's hard to complain when she basically pays my rent. I wish I could finish The Sinking City. I liked it. I got distracted by something. I can't remember why I stopped playing it. I genuinely just got distracted with something and then stopped playing it. I think I was ill. Whenever I take, like, a long break from playing a specific game, it's very rare that I go back to it. I'm definitely streaming Lobotomy Corporation tomorrow, I promise. Also, that guy I raided last night, a fucking VTuber, Responsible Senpai, I actually hung around and watched his stream for, like, about an hour and a half after I raided him. He's alright. She's pretty much the only reason I could afford to buy all this Eldritch paraphernalia. But best of all, she's smoking hot. I mean, she's cute. I wouldn't say... I mean, does it give away that I've got a type if I say that she's not got nothing on Lynetta? And also the fact that I immediately thought Lady Dimitrescu. Does that give anything away? Okay.
If I may be so bold, Well, I have something special to give you.
I think Dee finds everything smoking hot. A little bit, yeah. She's more on the cute side of it. Yeah, no, she's like, I'd describe her as cute, not hot. There's two very distinct aesthetics there. Oh, God, yes. Oh, hell, yes. Right this way. Yeah, I was going to say, Lynetta's in there. Do you really want to bring... Yeah, I got to go with them, I almost forgot. Actually, now's not a good time. I think you just give it to me out here.
It's not the kind of present I can give you out in the open.
A present that has to be given in private? Oh man, what could it be? Is she gonna hold my hand? Wait, I almost lost sight of things again. If Lynetta and Missy meet, I'm toast. Can I really not help myself with my life on the line here? Say something, idiot! D's type is yes. Yeah, precisely. Well, I can't get away right now. How about we meet up after work?
I can't go out after dark.
Right, I forgot her weird curfew. Yeah, it's definitely a weird curfew, and not that she, like, transforms into an abomination or something at night.
Why can't we just go inside? I really want to give you your present now.
Darling, what's taking so long? I miss you!
Is Lynetta coming to the door? I can hear her footsteps.
Oh, who is that? You have company over?
That's just the mailman! Oh, Dee is... Oh, he's thick as mince. He's a fucking idiot.
Inside your apartment?
Yeah, he really doesn't understand boundaries. It's fucked up. Shoot, I got my lame excuses mixed up. Is that... Sorry, did I just run into the house and slam the door? Oh man, she's pissed. Sorry, Missy. This is the other way I survived this. Cool. Turns out it was one of those door-to-door salesmen. They can be really pushy, you know?
No!
I don't want any!
To make them go away?
No, I got this! You just have to be persistent. Eventually they give up. Did she finally give up? Cool. I better smooth things over with her later, before she tries anything crazy. Especially now that she knows where I live. Better hurry through these rituals before there's more interruptions. Okay. She's sounding a bit regal out there, yeah. Oh! She might actually just be Hastur the Unspeakable rather than a cultist. Given that there is another day after... Also, I may have to, like, activate... Because it said that you need secrets to find, like, secrets. to unlock what is clearly the third chapter, the Nyarlathotep chapter. I might need to just look that up to find how to get the secrets, because I'm shit at secret hunting. Okay. You know what? No, I want to do this one now that I can. Oh, that was one of the secrets. Cool. Cool, alright. Metamorphosis. Do not attempt this ritual without the calling and invoke the depths. Okay, yeah, I've got the calling and invoke the depths. Okay. Christ, there's a lot. Cat ears might be the key. Not sure, but the counter had the same ears. And actually, the Nyarlathotep thing seemed to also have kind of cat ears as well. Cool, I am just horribly bleeding from the hands. Nice. Excellent. No, I'm into it. It's fine. Ensure his image appears in no way. Cool, let's get... Okay, let's just quickly make sure Cthulhu's not around. Cool. Okay... I'm just curious as to if there is actually things in the fog. Though, okay. Do not attempt. If you see or hear something strange, is not your imagination, be ready. Fucking Christ. Proceed in total darkness, no lights, no candles. Ensure his image appears in no way in poster or tapestry. Wear a ceremonial robe. Okay, so everything, yeah. Ceremonial robe and ritual necklace. Yep. Mask to distort my features. Yep. Hold a ceremonial knife on my person. Don't think I put it down after I used it to cut a weird mouth. Always remember the second step in the previous page. This is the point of no return. No light, no candles. Okay. What? Ah, okay. Hadn't realized the light was on.
Hello, handsome.
Cool, I've got a tentacle hand. Excellent. We can all see the bleeding mannequin, yeah? We can all see that, yeah?
Cool. And I thought you were cute for a human before. Now you're totally my type.
I'm squiddly, aren't I? I'm like a rubbery person from... Yeah, mirror, exactly, yeah. I'm trying to respond, but no sound is coming out of my mouth. Even when I try to shout as loud as I can, I can't even manage a whisper. Something is not right. What happened to me? Oh my god. So I think this is what I look like. But I've basically just sliced off my own face. Oh, big fan. Big fan. Big fan.
Darling, what are you looking at?
Oh, God. I'm just reading rituals, love.
Nothing, huh? You were looking at nothing?
Yep.
Is that the truth?
Yep. Hmm.
Did I scare you, darling?
No, but
I know what page you were on. And if I see you trying to cast that spell about nothing, you won't get past the second word.
I mean, should I do it, or just, keep on going? We need the stuff. Break up. Let the room be well lit. My room's very well lit. Bad end, yeah. Oh, hey, look! The bottom of my face came back! Worth it, Eldritch Mouth. Okay. Okay. I just need to do the metamorphosis thing again. Okay. Prepare offering. Illuminate the room to your comfort. Collect necessary items called storage. Ensure this symbol is present nearby. Chant. Okay. Is that it? Yeah, that's it. God damn it, I pressed the wrong button. I didn't mean to die. Shit. Damn, that's a lot of text. Okay. Get rid of that. Boop, boop. Hubba jubba hubba jubba hubba jubba wah. Okay. Now let's ideally try and put all my shit away without, like, breaking the game. Okay. Nope, not that one. Okay, need horrible eye symbol. God damn it, I went past it. Hang on. There we go. Horrible eye symbol. Collect the necessary item. Illuminate the room to my comfort. Yeah, that'll do. Collect the cold storage. Cool. Hubba jubba hubba jubba hubba jubba what?
That already smells delicious, darling.
I mean, it's milk and something in a pot. I don't...
All it needs is a little something and it'll be perfect. Hmm. I'm going to take a short walk outside while you finish. See you in a few, love.
We made a cake. Fascinating. Reach into oblivion. Oh, that's literally just that symbol is bleeding over to the next page. Short walk outside. Hold on a minute. My hand turned back from a tentacle. My hand's not a tentacle now. Odd. Okay. from Reach into Oblivion. Wear a ceremonial robe and a ritual knife. Get me my horrible eye. Get me my horrible robe. Have another life form on your person. Ah, fuck. We're about to kill the fucking turtle. Her name. Our poster's back. We've cut off our fingers. Something terrible is blocking the door. Read this or react as doing to start the ritual, clear all three pages. Do not open any doors, any blinds, or do not turn on any lights or snuff any existing lights so you attract their attention. Ensure this symbol is present nearby. Shit, that one. Cool. She's coming and sure this symbol is present nearby. Not cover your ears, you'll need them. Fine. Don't worry about it.
I can tell by the look on your face. You caught a glimpse of the real world now that I'm waking up.
Yeah. Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
Guess you aren't as sane as you thought, huh, darling? Oh, sweetie. Don't worry about reality. It doesn't have anything to do with you anymore.
I think I'm still in reality, though.
Though, I should tell you... Everything you saw and heard, it's still there.
By the way, the horrible face reaching out of the book, like that, fantastic. But, and once again, genuinely similar looking to a lot of the people I follow on Twitter. The art I follow on Twitter.
What you saw coming through your window is still coming through. Very soon, it'll be impossible to deny its presence, and even escaping reality won't protect you. If you like. I could move you to the front of the line and hand you painlessly myself. As thanks for waking me up. You wouldn't hear their screams anymore. Or feel that chill up your spine where that tentacle is already touching.
Maybe
you'd prefer to be saved for last. Have the whole doomed world all for yourself for a while. Though the things you'd see if you lingered. Being destroyed first or last. Which would you prefer? My darling.
Okay, call him. Still just that kind of fucked up then. Nice. Okay, the world outside is still just foggy. Okay. Very important question. Nope, all the horrible stuff is there. Cool. Dark Communion. Do not attempt this ritual without performing. Prepare offering a reach into oblivion. Let the room be well lit. Wear no robes or necklaces. Have the offering on your person. The cake's got blood on it! The cake's got blood on it! Nothing is just your imagination. Yeah, yeah, seems like that, yeah.
Delicious! Just perfect! I wish you could make offerings like this forever!
I could if you don't ever kill me!
Devoted darling, there is only one last spell to perform. Pledging yourself to me!
Take cool. Heart.
Your pledge of devotion will be the last act of humanity for all of time. The final words ever spoken by humankind will come from your fairy mouth and echo into oblivion.
And yeah, I'm still concerned that Missy's gonna show up and fuck me up. It's jam, Ethan. Jam and cave gas. Yeah, I know, yeah. This, you know what? I believe all of this is cave gas. I believe you on this one.
The privilege is yours alone.
Cool.
I may be inexperienced with human emotions, but even I know that saying goodbye to your world can be painful.
I don't think it will be for D, because D is, again, thick as mints.
Take all the time you need to make peace with
this
the
is
end.
Just the dying dreams of the guy in Iron Lung. Yeah, he got eaten by that fish at the end, and he's just hallucinating about fucking giant, hot, fucking octopus mom. Like, that's what he's dealing with. That's where he is.
Could you hit the lights for me, darling?
It upsets me that she is actually...
Thank you, my love.
Actually adorable. Cool. Still horribly wounded.
Thank you, my love.
She's asleep and couldn't stop you from casting. Lynetta? Did it work? My face and my hands are back to normal. Did I really do it?
Darling! Why?
Oh my god, she turned into a cuttlefish. Oh, she's turned into a... No, now she's cuter. No, stop her. No.
Why did you break her connection?
No.
And cut off from the rest of me.
Wait, are you...
How could you... Why did you break my heart?
I did what I had to do. Sorry, darling, the world's not ending today. I think we should see other people.
But why? Was I not good enough? Did you have a bad time on our date?
I can't deal with this. I can't.
Is there another woman?
No, none of that. It was pretty much just that you were going to end all of reality. Nope, that's it. That's the deal breaker.
What? But you woke me up in the first place!
Come on, we both know I got more than I bargained for.
Oh, darling. You realize I still have control here, right? If you want to smooch my real form, you have no choice but to do the spells over.
A squid is fine,
wait,
too.
What?
Oh my god! Oh my god! He's gonna... Also... I'm still pretty sure this is a cuttlefish and not squid. Oh dear, you're a fucking freak, man. Yeah, no, appropriate. Cool. The good enough end. Cool. True endings achieved. One of two. Okay, there's two. There's two. Two true endings.
Darling, what's wrong?
And there we go. Okay. Okay, now let's destroy the world this time.
Thank you, my.
No worries. Okay. Have a ritual knife on your person? Always do. Chant this 5 times to fill the heart. That's one. Excellent. Props to the devs/writers for little points like, yeah, she just socks him. Yeah, no, he deserves to be punched at that point. Honestly, this guy deserves to be punched about, like, 7 times. That's 3. That's 4. Just gonna quickly... Just curious to see if I've got horrible gashes where my throat and heart is. No. Didn't think of that! Didn't think of that! Did you, devs? Hugga jubba hugga hugga.
It's done. The last ritual. You did wonderfully.
Sick.
I'm afraid it's time for the dream and our date to end. That look on your face, darling.
I don't think I
had a wonderful
date. I don't think I have much of a face.
Because of you.
How can I have a look on my face? Depending on which version of reality we're thinking of, I've either got like just a massive fucking bleeding gash where my mouth was, or I'm a tentacle head. So I don't think I've got much of an expression anymore.
So why destroy me and all of reality? Why not just stay here with me? That's what you're thinking, right?
It's not what I'm thinking. It's probably what actually, I would be surprised if even Dee's thinking about that. Again, that seems a bit too fucking heady and elaborate for a thought from Dee.
Oh, my sweet mortal darling. I'm not doing this out of malice. You've had good dreams before, right?
I'm surprised if Dee was thinking. Yeah, like, I don't think he does much thinking.
Well, when you woke up, you destroyed those dream worlds and everything in them. Did you wake up because you hated those dreams?
Yes.
No.
Don't fucking tell me.
That you'd wake up eventually.
Don't fucking tell me.
I love humans, and I'll miss you sorely. Please let your last thoughts be about that.
Do I not get the smooch?
Don't think I forgot about my promise to you.
Yeah, I was gonna fucking say.
You're up, my darling. You've earned it.
Smooch button, smooch button. Yeah. Oh, God. Jesus, look at the... Just the screaming as the world is consumed. Is that her? Is that supposed to be her back there? And did I get... I think I got all the endings, didn't I? Yeah, cool. The King in Yellow. Okay, well, I've spoiled that for myself, haven't I?
Summer for love. First date.
New date. Let's go. Yeah, find all 3 secrets. It seems like the King in Yellow, based on the fact that it's got 6 fucking endings, it seems like this might be the larger part of the game. And I'm hoping both of the secrets are it to unlock this are in here. Chapter 2, the King in Yellow approaches. Now, the vital question is this continuing?
Chapter 2, the King in Yellow approaches.
Because there's no way this is like, I'm dead, right? I'm 100% dead. In a world terrorized by slavering shadows and tentacled nightmares, something as innocuous as an additional star in the night sky may be the most prophetic premonition of doom. For wherever the lurid golden light of the planet Carcosa shines, the long wicked shadow of the King of in Yellow is cast. I am still not 100% sure whether or not in... This is, again, hard left here. Whether or not the first season of True Detective actually is supposed to have secret hidden supernatural elements, or if it is just there's a cult who, like, read the King in Yellow and took it way too seriously. I think I have the King in Yellow. Somewhere. Yeah, I actually have the King in Yellow. Behind that mask lie echoes of decadence and disorder, masquerades of limitless cruelty and hideous laughter in equal part. I regret watching the next True Detective seasons. Yeah, I've never watched them. I heard they were shit and not continuing the plot of season one, and I was like, cool, well, I liked these characters and this plot. From what I understand, they even dropped the vague Lovecraftian elements after the first season, so it's just like not... It's basically just watching a different show, and I'm like, okay, well, I'm not interested anymore then. And of all the poor devils seduced by the lavish promises of the God King's court, the favored victims of the King's sadistic amusement are followers belonging to other deities. Cool. Massive yellow star. Cool. I'm in Carcosa. Oh, I've been grabbed as I die, haven't I? Huh? What? Where? Huh? Did I zone out? What was I doing? Damn, I'm having one hell of a brain fart. I can't remember for the life of me what I'm supposed to be doing. Everything feels so hazy. Was I going to work? Am I standing outside? I am standing outside, after all. Yeah. That's gotta be it. The sun is setting, and huge, which means it's probably around 7 a.m, which means I'm going to be crazy late. Fantastic. That's the beauty of working nights. I can't use the excuse that I overslept. Yeah, boss, I slept all day, sun up to sun down. That's why, I mean, I do that. I work nights. I sleep, yeah. I'm 6 hours early to my shift. Those sound like church's noontime bells. It's high noon? No way, they must be doing some special evening service or something. I can clearly see it's the golden hour right before sunset. I'll just have to ask someone for the time on my way to work. If it's not too late and I really huff it, I'll just get chewed out instead of fired. I'll still have to deal with being sweaty, but I'll figure that out when I get there. Ah, oh, cool, look, it's, Based on the silhouette, it's Joker from Persona 5. That is just Joker's silhouette. Someone's coming home. Perfect. Fingers crossed I'm not absolutely screwed. I mean, even from here, I can see he's wearing a masquerade mask. He's got blood all over him. Hey, man. Sorry to bother you. You wouldn't happen to have the time on you, would you? Oh, hey, it's Joker from the hit game Super Smash Brothers. I'm gonna kill you. I'm gonna physically throw you off of a balcony. I will take you to a balcony and throw you off. And I won't even throw your cane after you, so you won't even be able to get back up if you survive the fall. I will just throw you off a balcony. Hello? Hey! Hey! Is this guy ignoring me? No, he's a Persona protagonist. He can only talk in very specific situations. I'd say whatever and walk away, but he's unfortunately standing in the only stairway off this floor. The only way to exit this conversation is to shove past him. This guy's giving me such weird vibes, I don't want to go anywhere near him. The longer I look at him, this guy seems more and more suspicious. That odd posture, he's slowly swaying in an uncanny, disturbing way. Yeah, he wanted to talk, but his charm wasn't high enough, exactly. The collar of his shirt looks filthy, stained with splotches of deep browns and reds. Is he bleeding? Does he even live here? This is the top floor, and I thought I've met all of my neighbors. There are only 4 apartments up here. My only choices are to go inside and call the police, or to walk past this freaky guy. I don't have time to wait for the cops to show up, so I'll... Just as I take a step, I kick something weighty with my shoe. It's bright pink with golden accents. A book? What's... Lynetta! But I died! The world ended! The shock freezes me in place. I see you, buddies. And because I was so distracted, I didn't even notice them. Yep. I duck inside my room, slamming the door in the suspicious men's face. Fumbling with the locks in a panic, I manage to turn the deadbolt. I take a few fearful steps back into the room, clutching the book to my beating chest. I died! I like 100% died when I performed the final ritual, so why am I still here? Where is here? Oh, look at that! You know what? There's some really nice... Oh, fuck. Okay. Cool. Oh, dear. Anyway, what was I talking about? No, really, what was I talking about? Yeah, there's some really good artwork around of Haster the Unspeakable. I honestly prefer the look of Haster, the kind of empty robes with tentacle shit under the robes, than Cthulhu. I think Cthulhu is really played out visually. Because, like, everything fucking... like, everything uses Cthulhu imagery. Haster is still a bit less played out. Comes up a lot. Haster's normally the one that shows up after Cthulhu. If you're doing some Lovecraftian, first you go for Haster. No, first you go for Cthulhu, then if you want to be a bit more creative, you go for Haster. But there's some really cool Haster art. I would love some art of Haster the Unspeakable in my room. It'd be great. Haster the Hipster. Yeah. I mean, it's spelled with a U, but thanks for playing. Fucking idiot! I'm personally a fan of Neil Athertep. Oh, wait. Hang on. I want to quickly check something. I think one of my hard drives is called Neil Athertep. Hang on. Yeah, I've got... Okay. So, I've got... No, it's not. So, fun thing. I've got 4 hard drives, right? One of them is called Castamere, because I really enjoy... I like Game of Thrones and I like the Lannisters. Another one is called Mechanicus. And then the other two, my two main hard drives, are Relay and Carcosa. Because that's just how I be, I guess. But like in my room, I have nowhere to run. Lynetta! Lynetta! If Lynetta was here, she could explain this. Maybe there's something in this book that can save me. I need to hurry. Come on, Lynetta, where are you?
Who is this? Lynetta, you're trying to call.
You spelled it wrong. Also, just... Edward, fuck off with Haster the Hupster. I'm gonna fuck it. I am going to throw... It's not a joke. I'm going to throw you off a balcony. Missy? What are you doing in my room?
I just so happened to overhear you saying, Lynetta, where are you? You sounded like you were in trouble, so I let myself in.
How? How did you even get in here?
Your window is open.
Huh? No, it's not, and... Either way, I'm on the top floor, so how did you-
Lynetta sounds like a girl's name, right? This Lynetta is obviously the girl you stood me up for, isn't she?
Yes. What is her deal? I knew she'd be pissed I slammed that door in her face, but not so much that she wouldn't notice any of the things that's obviously wrong here. Why doesn't she care about those freaky things stalking me outside, or that my room is full of evil idols and ritualistic tokens? Yeah, don't think I didn't notice the Joker cosplay over here. I can explain all this stuff.
Let me guess. Accursed devices used to channel eldritch magics and do the bidding of outer gods.
Yep. Well, yeah. Exactly right. Did you just randomly guess that?
No, I've just been playing coy. I know exactly what you've been doing.
Cool.
You know what this is, don't you?
Yes. It's a survival guide for dating you, presumably. yeah, with the yellow sign on it. That's the thing, because I've been getting tattoos, and I'm getting the Malkavian clan symbol tattooed there in a couple of weeks. I've got Nurgle up there. I've been thinking about getting a Lovecraft tattoo as well. Yeah. I'm not sure where I'd get it, though, or which one. I'm tempted by the Elder sign. But, you know, it might also be fun just to, like, hide, like, the symbol of Hasta the Unspeakable on me somewhere. Just, like, in a weird place that you wouldn't necessarily expect. So, just, you know, kind of, almost like a fucking, like it's like a secret hidden, you know, it'd be on brand for a hid, for a Lovecraft tattoo, for a Lovecraft cult tattoo. Just have it hidden somewhere weird. It's a golden version of my book. The book I used to perform rituals for Lynetta. Hers looks way more ornate than mine. Considering I ended reality with mine, I can't imagine how dangerous hers must be. Wait a minute. The sky, that suspicious man outside, they all match Missy's book. I will also say this, I do genuinely think, because Lynetta was explicitly a starspawn, which meant that she was basically a child of Cthulhu. I want the yellow sign on my neck on my wrist. I was thinking about my neck as well, actually. Neck tattoo. The thing is, I don't know how picky the place I work will be. Because the place I work has got really open uniform policies. In that basically, as long as I don't have a swastika on me, and it's not on my, and I don't have any tattoos on my face, they don't give a shit. But I'm wondering if, like, a tattoo there, if they'd consider that on my face. You know? I mean, it'd be covered by the collar of my shirt, but I don't know. Because I wouldn't mind a Hasta the Unspeakable tattoo, though, like a yellow sign there. That'd be cool, especially because if it was like there and I'm wearing a t-shirt, it would like just, you know, it would just kind of peek out. It would be, you know, I think that would look cool. The fact that I spend so much time thinking about tattoos now is weird. If it's covered, would they even know you have it? Yeah, 100%. I can't keep my mouth shut. I would tell them. I'm awful. I cannot keep my mouth shut. She made all this happen. Oh God, when I expected her to do something crazy, I thought she was just going to show up with a hatchet or something. Just to be clear, I think I forgot what I was saying, but yeah. This bitch, if she is specifically the king in yellow, she is infinitely more dangerous than Lynetta. Because Lynetta was essentially a descendant, a subsidiary, a subordinate of a high priest of evil gods. Hasta is an evil god. Like, Hasta is a god. Missy, look, I'm sorry. I just got wrapped up in something. Please, don't.
Sorry? You're sorry? Why are you acting so afraid of me?
Could you stop playing coy? Oh god, she actually did that. Woo-hoo-hoo!
You know what this book is capable of?
Yeah, I do, yeah. I know all too well, but I also know that these incantations take at least 5 seconds to pronounce, and that's if she gets it right on the first try. So, worst case, I have 5 seconds to stop her. If I dash for my ritual knife behind her, I might be able to kill her before she does something terrible to me. If I can distract her, I might be able to buy myself more time. The eye patch just swapped so- The eye patch did just swap sides. I hadn't spotted that. Yeah. Missy, look, I'll do whatever you want.
I can be rather demanding.
Yeah, I've noticed. Name your price.
So bold. In that case, I have 3 commands.
Now, is that a mistake or is that intentional?
Number one, you'll address me as Your Highness from now on.
Cool.
So when I come
She is the king in yellow. She is the king in yellow. 100%. When she comes home, she wants to move in. But that means, whatever. It's not like I'm gonna have to actually follow through on these. At least one of us is about to die. As you wish, Your Highness. What else?
Number two, you'll quit your job so you can spend every waking moment catering to me, your one and only.
Sure, whatever. Just a little bit more until I'm sprinting in range of the knife.
Number three, you'll obey every order and whim I have, absolutely, without question. Do you agree to my terms?
Absolutely. 100%.
Absolutely. What?
Absolutely, Your Highness. Fuck it.
If you will do whatever I ask, then there's no need to use any of these dreadful spells on you. As a matter of fact, I believe you can help me with them. Here.
She just handed over her book without a second thought. Yellow energy pulses and crackles from my fingertips. She not here to hurt me?
Confused. I've liked you for a long time, And you're a capable bookkeeper.
That is a really cool poster, sorry.
There's no reason we can't simply work together.
Yeah, yeah, right. That is... To be honest with you, I'd have that poster in my room. Like, I would just have that in my room, quite happily.
After all, a relationship based on threats of violence and fear is no good, right?
You know, the relationship with Lynetta was essentially in spite of the violence and fear. Like, it was more just a bloody-minded refusal to acknowledge the fact that she was going to destroy the world. Right. We narrowly escaped with our lives just now, but something is bothering me. How does she remember that I stood her up in the reality that ended under Lynetta's awakening? And how did she get in through my window? And how she was able to climb several stories dressed like that and then pass through my locked window without breaking it? There's only one possible answer. All right, Your Highness, I'm ready to enter my lifetime of servitude to you. I just have one small request first.
Being?
The fucking Worcestershire sauce again! Oh, God. Could you tell me what this is?
Your Worcestershire sauce? What about it?
So, you're an eldritch god disguised as a human! Yes! No! No scent! Nothing but a monster can pronounce Worcestershire sauce! Fuck! I fucked it up! This game is like actually funny. Like, this game is like genuinely funny.
What? How did you figure that out suddenly?
I mean, to be honest with you, I worked it out immediately. I'm amazed it took D this long. Isn't it obvious that no human being can pronounce Worcestershire sauce? Gonna ask every future girlfriend this. Yeah, yeah, I'd do that as well, but I'm gonna die alone. Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Worcestershire. Of course not, it's an eldritch loanword. Why else would it be spelled like that?
Yeah.
I was careless. After all this time I wasted trying to seduce you in this slovenly form.
Yeah, you should have tried using your eldritch form instead. I would have fallen in love immediately.
What?
What?
You think cosmic entities are attractive? As a human?
Okay. 3D women are fine, but fourth dimensional girls with non-Euclidean geometry are smoking hot. They've got curves I can literally get lost in. By the way, just want to quickly... Non-Euclidean geometry is one of the silliest things in... One of the silliest Lovecraft terms, because if I remember correctly, non-Euclidean, I can't remember exactly what it means, but it actually just means something incredibly pedestrian. Hang on. I'm going to quickly double check. I think it might just mean shit where there's curves. Geometry. Definition. But I think that's all it means. Like, it's... Yeah, it's basically just geometry in a world that... geometry on a curved surface, so it's just geometry, because we live on a curved surface. Like, it's just... It's one of those things where... Yeah, like... It's one of those things where whenever it gets mentioned, I just remember the fact that H.P. Lovecraft was not a very smart man. H.P. Lovecraft basically didn't have an education. What H.P. Lovecraft had was he had no social life, crippling social anxiety, and a lot of, and just a shitload of old books, which is where he picks up a lot of these things. And then it's like, I watched a video that kind of ruined a lot of stories of his for me. It was Overly Sarcastic Productions video talking about him. I think that's, yeah, OSP, yeah. Where they mentioned that there are several, stories that are just him freaking out about, modern technology. Like, The Color Out of Space was him, I believe, was him being freaked out by the concept of UV light. And he had one called Cold Air, which came out around the time that air conditioning had been invented. So it was just, he was freaked out by the idea of air conditioning. Like, he knew a lot of big words, but didn't know how to use them properly. So, like, he just... Like, I love H.P. Lovecraft. Like, I adore his work. Big fan. But he was kind... He at the end of the day, in a lot of ways, he was just kind of an idiot with a dictionary. Like, he was an idiot who knew a lot. Except he didn't have a dictionary, because he didn't know what half of them fucking meant. Yeah, so the non-Euclidean thing is, yeah. Anyway, fourth dimensional curse, the non-Euclidean geometry of smoking heart. They've got curves I can literally get lost in.
If I had known that you're attracted to my cosmic godhood, I would have just led with that.
I can't believe that this is... Actually, this guy was being actively seduced by Haster the Unspeakable.
Allow me to properly introduce myself. I am Haster, King in Yellow, Heiress to Carcosa. Charmed, I'm sure.
Oh, it's Esther the Unspeakable. Okay. Also, again, this design just dead ass looks like something you would see in Persona 5, right? It also, genuinely, I wouldn't be surprised if a chibi-fied version of this design was an abnormality I had to deal with at some point in Lobotomy Corporation. Like, it's, yeah. She's gorgeous. A bona fide Eldritch... Is that bona fide or bona fide? I've never actually been sure how you pronounce that. Eldritch King. In my room! It's completely forgotten about Lynetta. Does not care anymore. All my fantasies of smooching an eldritch horror are coming true. An eldritch royalty to boot. Bonafide. Okay. The King in Yellow sounds familiar. I can't remember why. My memory of my other existence is kind of fuzzy. What I do remember is that her followers tend to be incredibly violent towards cultists loyal to other gods. Like Lynetta. Shit, I kinda got swept up in the moment and almost forgot I already pledged fealty to a different god, this reality or not. Wait, I'm sorry. I'm already involved with another god. I'm following Lynetta.
So loyal, so faithful and devoted. That's why I want you to be my follower instead.
Again, Lynetta's not a god. Lynetta is beneath Cthulhu and Cthulhu is not a god. They're just eldritch, they're eldritch creatures, but effectively, Cthulhu is just a really scary alien. So there. Shut up. Fuck you. I know what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about!
In exchange for serving me, I shall grant you anything you desire. Wealth, power, whatever that rotten witch Lynetta offered you, I can double it.
Two smooches. I think D thinks she's a god. But yeah, D definitely thinks she's a god, because D's thick as mints. Like, she promised me a smooch.
There I shall. What?
Like, real. I genuinely actually really like this design. Like, she. It just really looks like a Persona or. It looks like a Persona or something from the Lobotomy Corporation.
You handed over your reality to her? For a singular smooch? Are you mad?
No, I'm thick as mints. I don't know how many times I can say it. You heard me, so you match her offer then?
I suppose. If that's all you're selling the world for, then a smooch can be... arranged.
This one is hot. Hey, again, I don't want to be giving people any indication that I might have a type, but while I do really like this design, Lynetta was more attractive to me. I don't want people thinking I'm cool. No way. You promised to double it. That's two smooches.
Hold on a minute.
Two of them on the lips.
Alright. Two smooches, lip to lip, satisfied.
I am genuinely surprised by it. Like, I thought this was just going to be a dumb novelty, but this A, has legitimately creepy moments, and B, is genuinely quite funny.
Usually, my followers ask for inordinate wealth, unquestionable fame and influence, or some lavish indulgence.
Bitch, the world's gone! The world's gone. The world's gone. Like, what the fuck does wealth mean? The world's got, like, the reality's fucked. The fuck does wealth mean?
Nobody's ever dared to ask to kiss me before, so...
She's blushing for real.
You really want to smooch me? Well, your terms are amenable. Suffice it to say, I'll expect you to perform your scenes flawlessly in exchange.
Yeah, sure. Scenes?
The prompt book I gave you contains the script for The King in Yellow.
Yep, okay, that makes sense, because The King in Yellow... The titular King in Yellow is a play that is connected to Hastur the Unspeakable. Also, little thing worth noting, The King in Yellow? Not Lovecraft. I've got a copy of the actual... Hang on. I'm wearing pajamas, so back up. Yeah, I've got my thing here. The King in Yellow isn't actually Lovecraft. The King in Yellow is, but I don't know if you see that, it's Robert W. Chambers. I can't remember when it was originally released. Like, when it was originally published. I think it predates him, actually. I'm genuinely not sure, this isn't telling me. But yeah, it was one of those things, that... but The King in Yellow predates Lovecraft, and it's... I'm gonna double check, I'm pretty sure The King in Yellow predates Lovecraft. I just don't know the actual... I want to make sure I'm right, you know? Yeah, it's... Wait, okay. A book of short stories. Yeah, it was published in 1895. So yeah, it predates Lovecraft by a good bit. And it's basically just one of the things that he had adopted and made reference to in his work. Kind of like how there's a lot of references to Conan the Barbarian. Like, that, like, technically, I think the world of Conan the Barbarian is canon with the Cthulhu mythos. Like, that is just an age in history that actually happened in the Cthulhu mythos. He just liked it, and he just, like, adopted parts of it. So he basically co-opted Hastur the Unspeakable and the King in Yellow. But even then, I don't think he did a lot. Yeah, back in those days, writers referenced themselves a lot. Yeah, well... The Conan the Barbarian thing is actually specifically because I've got the book. Is it Robert E. Howard? Yeah, I haven't read Conan the Barbarian, but I've got the collected works on my thing. It's on my pile of shit I need to get around to reading. But I believe that Robert E. Howard and H.P. Lovecraft, I think they knew each other. If I remember correctly, those two were friends, which is why they referenced each other a lot in their work. But yeah, the King in Yellow is just something that H.P. Lovecraft adopted into his own work. And then, I don't think he really did much with it, but then after he died, I believe, like, he had a lot of stuff that was being written by other people and being, like, I think, like, August Derleth and shit like that, and added a lot of stuff to the Lovecraft mythos. I think, I can't say the name. It's the Black Goat. I can't say the name because the name literally involves the... phonetically a slur, Shub-Arath, you know? I believe while referenced in Lovecraft's work was mostly something that August Derleth wrote about after Lovecraft's death, when Derleth basically took over, like, the Cthulhu mythos, effectively. And I think a lot of the Hastur the Unspeakable being, like, directly involved in a lot of stuff in Lovecraft actually came from kind of that era when a lot of stuff was being written by Derleth. Also, can I just quickly say that is one of the best names for a horror writer doing Lovecraftian-style fiction ever. August Derleth. That was an actual human being's fucking name. August Derleth. Sorry, we're taking a break. I need to quickly check if August Derleth... Yeah, no, he was born August Derleth. It's not like... Yeah, he was August William Derleth. Fucking wild. Incredible name. But yeah, no, yeah, so H.P. Lovecraft didn't write Hasta. It was Robert W. Chambers, and then that Lovecraft like took that and referenced it, and then the role of Hasta in the mythos was expanded by August Derleth after Lovecraft's death. Okay, let's get back to the game, shall we? Huh? You mean this spell book that I was so afraid of is just a damn play? Okay, no, it's not just a damn play. The King in Yellow is the play, and the play is terrifying. There's a really good series of SCPs based on the King in Yellow. And the first SCP, I think it's called the Hanged King's Tragedy, and it's basically, like, the SCP's take on the King in Yellow. And you can then, like, follow, that down a rabbit hole of, like, an entire canon of the Hanged King. I fucking love all that shit. There's just so much excellent stuff about the Hanged King. I fucking love that. If you've not read, there's definitely something out there, like, a list of, like, a reading order for the canon of the Hanged King's Tragedy and the Hanged King's stuff, but that is just fantastic. Absolutely love that stuff. I'm having so much fun. Sorry, I'm playing a visual novel that's actually making me laugh and is scaring me and is giving me an excuse to go on, like, multiple really long tears about my very specific niche interests. This is a very... Ethan's having a good day. Ethan's having a very good day. This thing's just a playbook. Where are all the power-invoking rituals?
Is this some sort of peasant joke that I'm too rich to understand?
Far fuck you.
No, we aren't barbaric swamp folk casting hocus-pocus in a cave. We have a little class. To invoke my power, my play must be performed perfectly.
Perfectly? I don't always get these rituals, scenes right the first time. What happens if I botch my lines or set a scene
Your
wrong?
Your performance will receive a scathing review in the Carcosan Times publication. And you'll also be killed.
Cool. Gulp. I'm getting those smooches, no
like
matter what.
Leg, dearest.
Cool. Is she, like, in here? Oh yeah, there she is. Wait. Oh, what? Oh, that. Okay, that's interesting. Hey, Esther. What the fuck?
Do that.
What? All I did was say hello.
Don't speak my name, dearest. There's a reason I am she who is not to be named. A mortal saying Esther summons me to them.
Yeah, it's again same with Hasta the Unspeakable. It's the same call. If I can't say your name, what am I supposed to call you?
You have many options. You may call me Your Majesty, Your Grace, my King. You could even call me Your Royal Highness if you're feeling particularly subservient.
Come on, Tim. Come here. Esther, 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 Esther. Excellent.
Stop that!
Also, I just realized we're called Dearest now instead of Dee. Oh, darling. Fascinating, okay. Okay, we got a big old ugly mask. That. Turtle's still alive. Interesting. Have a look in here. Quickly wash this. Okay. We had a kiss on our forehead, didn't we? The first time I looked. Ooh, all my shit's red now instead of pink. Call her girlfriend, yeah. If I go out here, am I going to get killed by the cultists immediately? Oh, no, they're gone. Okay. Fascinating. Of course the turtle's still alive. Your heresy was in the last episode wasn't real. Yeah, no. Well, heresy's never real. Okay. Okay. Hang on. Okay. Setting exterior in view of the city. I genuinely. I genuinely really like how they've, like, structured this, actually. Click and drag. Greetings, stranger, fortune fellow. 'Tis a party for which I bellow. I invite the king in yellow, so come... Oh, I can't read the whole thing. Oh, it is coming... Oh, it's actually coming up down here. Okay. Greetings, stranger, fortune fellow. 'Tis a party for which I bellow. Invite the king in yellow, so come all ye in ether... One of the stories in here is actually... I'm pretty sure it's actually called The King in Yellow. Yeah, yeah. I'm just trying to see if this actually has any of the dialogue from the actual play. I can't be bothered searching through that. Obviously, there isn't an actual play called The King in Yellow, but, you know, often stories making reference to The King in Yellow have excerpts from it, you know, in order to, like, you know, you get it. Kind of like how, you know, there's no actual Necronomicon, but they have excerpts from the Necronomicon and stuff. So come all ye in Itil? Christ, who named this? George R. R. Martin and From Software making a joke about Elden Ring? Wear thine masks... Thetil. Yeah, actually, it could be a thorn. I think that's what that's called, isn't it? When a Y is being used to represent a TH sound. A thorn. Wear thine masks upon you to my masquerade until he may come to lost Thetil. I'm going to say Yetil. Yethil? I'm going to say Yetil. Yethil? Yethil. Let's go with Yethil. I don't know, but let's go with Yethil. I know that's not what it spells, but fuck it. It's the closest I'm getting. Hope for us there may be still.
Shadows lengthen, dim streets darken. To the curfew thou must hearken. Why so loudly dost thou bark in the dim city of Yethil?
Oh, Yethil. She says it. Okay, it's Yethil. I was right the first time! She thinks it's Yethil. Then again, this game thinks that Rulia, Relay, is pronounced... Really, so...
Only much attention, quite unwholesome you'll instill from the souls of poor Yetil. Why attract so much ill will?
That is just what I must seek, see hidden somewhere amongst the meekly. 'Tis one invitee I seek, he shall all my mistakes undo. 'Tis the king in yellow, whose great wealth I shall accrue. When his shadow passes through, wealth will come to I and you.
Lo, your plans shall surely languish, and this whole town will know anguish, for the king is whom they say, which shall this city indeed smite.
I mean, that might have that... The really might have just been for the pun. Yeah, but the game never said Relay in any other way, so the game's fucking stupid. And I hate it, and it's 0 out of 10 for that. No matter how much enjoyment I've gotten out of the rest of it, 0 out of 10 for that and that alone.
If he comes, Yetil, and you and I will know his might. I'll be lost within a night. What reward is worth that?
3 hours after. Hello, guys. What did I miss until now? The first date. We're on the second date now, dealing with the King in Yellow. Oh god. Wearing this expensive clothing, pardon from my family's loathing, lasting till I'm decomposing all my friends whom strife I've caused. Yes, preparing for this night, their forgiveness is the cause. They shall all be proud because I have brought the king to us. Why, thank you. That was... Ah, Intrasox? Thank you for the follow. Why, thank you. That was actually pretty fun. I haven't gone to flex my acting chops since high school.
You're a stranger to the stage. I can tell.
Yeah, I was a theater kid. My school did Macbeth. When I was in secondary school... And college! I was a theater kid. Studied drama in college. Yeah. Got a very bad grade despite doing it for my final performance. Excerpts from The Resistible Rise of Arturo Uy. And despite the fact that I despite the fact that it was a comedy, and I made the entire room burst out laughing, because my teacher was, and this is true, famously a pervert who always treated his male students like crap and massively creeped on his female students, he tried to fail me until there was genuinely complaints from teachers and the parents of other students and the other students on the course. And I was not popular. Everyone enjoyed my performance and they thought it was complete bullshit that he tried to fail me. Massive fucking creep, that guy. Massive fucking creep, and he hated his male students. He really did. When I was a theatre kid, my school did Macbeth.
A virtuoso of the bard, are we? If you've performed Shakespeare, then you must be an actor of sufficient ability to survive my play.
Maybe if I hadn't had a completely fucking shithole of a teacher, I might have continued pursuing drama into my, into university. And then I would have, but I'd still be getting exactly as little use out of my degree as I'm getting out of my film degree, but there we go.
Tell me, what role were you? The leading man, I presume.
I was tree number four.
I wasn't aware that was a role.
It's not.
You weren't even the leading tree.
Don't worry, I was actually Macbeth.
I thought you said you were a tree.
Acting.
Oh,
fascinating. No, this motherfucker was the tree. Whoa, hey, what's happening to you?
Don't fret, dearest. Something is simply passing between my planet's light and your bedroom. A cloud, perhaps.
McBirch, yeah.
You know the proverb, wherever the golden light of Carcosa shines, the shadow of the unspeakable one is cast? It's a literal rule.
Not heard that proverb, to be honest.
I can only be wherever the light of my planet star Carcosa shines.
That is going to be interesting for later if I have to try and break up with her.
In other words, I can't reach you at night when you're not standing in natural light, or if anything obstructs your view of Carcosa.
That explains why Missy had a weird daytime curfew. She'd literally vanish when the sun sets. What a Cinderella-like curse. That also explains how she got in my room. My window may have been locked, but the curtains were open, allowing the light in. So she can't get into my room if I close my curtains.
Aww, I was quite enjoying my time with you. I wanted to stay a little longer. Alas, parting is such sweet sorrow. It may be some time until your sky clears. Until then, I bid you adieu.
See ya. She kissed him on the forehead! Well, looks like I have one hell of a choice to make. Lynetta hasn't been summoned yet, and Esther is stuck outside for the moment. So I have a moment to collect my thoughts. Between Lynetta and Astaire, who do I want to smooch? Or maybe more accurately, who am I more afraid of? Do I stay with Lynetta, or do I follow Astaire this time around? She is offering twice as many smooches, after all. I need to make my choice. If I want to stay with Lynetta, then I should focus on casting spells from her book. If I want to smooch Esther, I should open my window again and the clouds clear and use Esther's book. And if I try going for both, well, walking down the middle of the road is bound to get me run over. As long as they aren't both in the room at the same time, I should be safe, right? Oh man, what am I gonna do? Either way, I need to talk to Lynetta. She might be an avatar of world-ending calamity, but she might be able to help me get my head straight. Speaking of my head, why does my forehead feel kind of sticky? Let's go back in here. What's the point of doing Lynetta again? I assume she's got, like, different dialogue. Yeah. Oh, good! No, good. I've already got horrible bleeding hands. Like, we've got horrible bleeding hands. Okay. Okay. Let's turn off all the lights. Finally put on the ritual necklace. When all is complete, chant. Hoogjabat, hoodabat, hoodabat, hip, 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 deboo. Wrong candles. Hoodabat, hoodabat, hip, hip, hippity, hoppity, hippity, hoo.
Darling, it's you!
Yeah, hi! I named you. Oh! I'm gonna take the Hasta poster. Yeah, maybe I should have. Oh well. Hey, Lynetta. Nice to see her, despite everything I've been through so far. Sure, she may have ended the reality I was from, but she never lied or deceived me in any way. That is true. She was completely upfront about it. She told me upfront what would happen, and I did it willingly. That said, I'm really glad you're here, but can you tell me what happened to me, to that world we dated in?
Reality fell to me. Nothing there exists anymore. Like a dream that ends.
Just as I thought, only... Then why am I still here? Why did I survive when the rest of that reality didn't?
Oh, darling, don't make me say it. It's embarrassing.
Oh, did she say... Oh, did she save us and move us to another reality?
You're still here because I'm still dreaming about you.
Oh, no, why is that cute? Oh, fuck, no. She destroyed the world and it was like horrible and why? Oh, that's cute though. She's adorable! And tall. I don't have a type, don't think about it.
Everything in existence is being dreamed about by at least one Eldritch God. So as long as you're on my mind, you'll exist somewhere.
Hold on a minute. That means, hang on. That's actually kind of sweet in a terrifying cosmic way. Yeah, I just... If we abandon her for Esther, then we're probably going to be in trouble. What would happen if every god stopped dreaming at the same time? What if you woke up all at once?
Everything, including all of the gods, would cease to be.
Also, I've just realized... We're gonna get to the end of this scene, and then I'm enjoying this, but then, I'm gonna hit the VOD. Not the VOD, I'm gonna hit the end slate, and then I'm gonna hit an ad break, and then we're gonna pause, because, my sister's not here, which means I need to sort the dogs out. So we're gonna get to the end of this conversation, then we're gonna take a break. But we'll be back with more. I'm gonna keep playing this until my only war game tonight, because I'm having a good time. And that can just happen at any time.
Nah, don't worry. There's about 50 of us total. So the chances of all of us being awake at the same time are low.
Yeah, cool. Gulp, there's only like 50 of you in all. She probably knows Esther very closely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's not family, great. Huh?
Family? Why would you say her name? You know it teleports her to you.
Darling, I told you not to mention other women while we're together. Especially not my sister.
Hester or Esther's half-brothers or half-sister in this case with Cthulhu. Oh! I didn't know that! You've actually educated me. I didn't know that Hester... Because Hester... The Hester stuff... As I said earlier, a lot of Hester's place... in the Cthulhu mythos came with August Dereleth, and I've not really read any of the stuff that Dereleth did. Like, I've not read post-H.P. Lovecraft Cthulhu stuff, really. So, yeah, I don't... Sister?
I can't stand that prissy little boyfriend stealing...
Don't, have a great relationship with
him? Absolutely not! We've been fighting over planets and followers for eons! It wouldn't be a stretch to call us nemesis.
Thanksgiving dinner must be awkward. Whew, good thing I wash my face. Playboy instincts jumping out here. Ah! Would something bad have happened if I hadn't washed my face? Ah! That's cool. If Lynette saw that lipstick smear on my forehead, I'd be in hot water right about now. Well, I still am in hot water now, actually. I've gotten involved with her sister. A messy affair is bad enough, but with a family member? I'm toast if she finds out. Esther. Looks like the clouds haven't cleared yet. I'll be able to see her right now. I wouldn't be able to see her right now if I wanted to. For now, I should work through the net of spells again. Eldritch Hand said my ass last time. I better cast that one in case I'm unable to talk again. Sheesh. Listen to myself. What the hell is wrong with me, man? Okay. So, here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna say 10, 15 minutes. Let's go 15 minute break. And then I'll be back. I'm just gonna actually get a timer up. But, yeah, I'm gonna play the VOD. Not the VOD, why do I keep saying the VOD? The end slate? Just for VOD purposes, so it's easier for me to stick it on YouTube. You know, I'll know when this ends. But then I will be back in about 15 minutes. Because I hit this mute button, don't worry about it. Because I'm having a great time, so we'll do that. Okay. So, yeah. For VOD purposes, that's going to be all for me for now. See you next time. End slate coming up. Then an ad break. And then a proper break. And I'll see you in a bit. It's going to be the first time I've run an ad on any of my fucking streams in genuinely a year. I don't run ads normally. I don't do breaks normally. Okay. Back in a bit.